Now welcome once again students, here I am going to give the revision of the exercise 1.1. So students, here I have written question number 1, using appropriate property find. I have written the second part of the question. Now if you are going to find the value of this, now here you can find, here it is 2 by 5, here it is also 2 by 5. So you can take the 2 by 5 common in both, that is the multiplication of these two values, and here it is the multiplication of these two values. So these two you need to write together. So it can be written like 2 by 5 into minus 3 by 7, that value. And if you are going to write it with this value, so it can be written as 1 by 14 into 2 by 5. Now what is the rest of the value? That is minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. So students, what I had done here, only I had changed the position. Now here, that is the position is changed, values are same. So there will be no effect on the answer. Now here, 2 by 5 is here also and here. So I can take common 2 by 5. So 2 by 5 I have written and I can take the common. So here it will be minus 3 by 7. After taking 2 by 5 common, that will be minus 3 by 7. And here 2 by 5 is taken as common. So it will be 1 by 14. Bracket is closed. Minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. Now it can be written as 2 by 5, and now here 7 and 14, what will be the LCM? That will be 14, that is the addition. So here you need to take the LCM, that is the 14. 7 2 is 14, 2 3 is 6, minus 6, and it will be plus 1, minus. Here you can simplify that 3 2 is 6, that is the multiplication. So minus 1 by 2 2 is 4, that will be minus 1 by 4. Now here it is 2 by 5 into minus 6 plus 1, that will be minus 5 by 14. Minus 6 plus 1 equal to minus 5, and upon 14, that will be 14, minus 1 by 4. Now these two are multiplied, so multiply that. 5 and minus 5 will be cancelled, and 2 7 is 14, and 5 and it will be minus 1. So minus 1 into 1, that will be minus 1 upon 7, that will be minus 1 upon 7, and it will be minus 1 by 4. So that is minus 1 by 7 minus 1 by 4. Now you need to add it and you need to simplify, then you will add. So what will be the LCM? LCM will be 28. Then 7 4 ja 28, 4 into minus 1 minus 4, 4 7 ja, and it will be minus 7. So it is minus 11 upon 28. So answer of the second part is minus 11 upon 28. So here it is the appropriate property that will be used to solve this kind of question. So that is the solution of the second part. Now students, I am going to explain about the additive inverse. Additive inverse of any number will be negative of that number. For example, if I am going to ask what is the additive inverse of 2 by 5. So additive inverse of 2 by 5 will be minus 2 by 5. Only you need to change the sign. If I am going to ask what is the additive inverse of minus 3 by 7. So if it is negative, so its additive inverse will be positive. That will be plus 3 by 7. So students, whatever the fraction is given and it is just the additive inverse, only you need to write the its negative. If it is positive, so that will additive inverse will be negative, and if it is negative, so its additive inverse will be positive. So by this way you will find the additive inverse of any number. Now students, multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse of any number will be the reciprocal, that is also called the reciprocal. If I am going to ask what is the multiplicative inverse of 3 by 5. So what will be the reciprocal of 3 by 5? That will be 5 by 3. So the multiplicative inverse of 3 by 5 is 5 by 3. If I am going to ask what is the multiplicative inverse of minus 2 by 7. So if number is negative, so its multiplicative inverse will be also negative. So its multiplicative inverse will be minus 7 by 2. So whatever the number is given, students, you need to only write the reciprocal of that number with the sign. If positive number is there, so its multiplicative inverse will be positive, and if negative number is there, so its multiplicative inverse will be negative. Now it is the way, if you are given the number like this, find the multiplicative inverse of 2 whole 1 by 5. So first you need to convert that number in the improper fraction. So it will be 5 2 is 10, 10 1 11. So that will be 11 by 5. This fraction is equal to 11 by 5. Now what is the reciprocal multiplicative inverse of 11 by 5? That will be 5 by 11. So if you are given this kind of number, so first convert this number in this form, and after that you can write the reciprocal of that multiplicative inverse of the number. If I am going to ask that which number have the इट्स मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स दैट इज द सेम, यानी विच नंबर हैव इट्स ओन मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क वन, वट इज द मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स ऑफ वन, सो दैट विल बी वन. सो वन इज द नंबर हुज मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स इज वन. इज देयर एनी अदर नंबर हुज मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स विल बी द सेम नंबर? यस, दैट इज द माइनस वन. वट इज द मल्टीप्लीकेटिव, इफ माइनस वन कैन बी रिटेन एज माइनस वन अपन वन, so its multiplicative inverse will be again minus 1 upon 1, that is equal to minus 1. So there are the two numbers whose multiplicative inverse will be the same number, 1 and minus 1. These are the two numbers whose multiplicative inverse are the same. If I am going to ask that which number doesn't have its multiplicative inverse, is any number whose multiplicative inverse will not exist, so that number is 0. 0 is the number whose multiplicative inverse doesn't exist. If I am going to ask that what is the multiplicative inverse of 0, if you are going to write 1 upon 0, so 1 upon 0, that is not a rational number, so that is not existing. So here 0 is the number whose multiplicative inverse does not exist. So if anyone asks that what is the number which multiplicative inverse doesn't exist, so that number will be 0. Now if I am going to ask that is there any number whose additive inverse will be same as the number? So is there number is there whose additive inverse will be same? So if I am going to ask that this question, additive inverse, so if 0 is the number, what will be the additive inverse of 0? So you can say if you are going to write minus 0, so 0 is the number which is neither taken as positive nor negative, so the additive inverse of 0 is 0. So 0 is the number whose additive inverse will be 0, the same number. Now students, here are certain properties. Now here commutative property. What is the means of commutative property? If you are going to take the two numbers and if you are going to do any mathematical calculation and if you are going to change the order of the number and if the answer is doesn't going to be affected, that is called the commutative property. Here I had written 5 plus 7 equal to 7 plus 5. Here only I had changed the position of the number. So 5 I have written here first, then 7 and second. Now here I have written 7 and after that I have written 5. But if you are going to add both will be same, both the answer will be 12. So in the addition, that is called the commutative property. In the same way, if I am going to multiply these two, first I have written 2 by 5, then 3 by 5. Now here I have written 3 by 5 first and after that 2 by 5. The both the multiplication will be same. So that property is called the commutative property. If you are going to take two numbers and if you are going to do the mathematical calculation in which answer is doesn't going to be affected, so that is called the commutative property. Now in the associative property, here you are going to take the three numbers. Here I have written 2 plus 3 plus 5, 2 plus 3 plus 5. Both are same. Only here I had changed the position of the bracket. First I am going to add these two and after that I will add 2 here. And here I will add these two and after that I will add 5. But the answer is doesn't going to be affected. So that's why here associative property is going to be followed. In the same way in the multiplication also the associative property is going to be followed. So these are the properties which will be used in the rational numbers. Commutative property and associative property. Student, commutative and associative property will be only followed in the rational number in the case of addition and multiplication. It doesn't going to be followed in the case of division and subtraction. So that commutative and associative property will be followed only in the case of addition and multiplication. Now students, in the book certain questions are given, that is the one line solution. Here it is given, write the rational number that does not have a reciprocal. So I discussed that which rational number does not have a reciprocal, that is the 0. The 0 is the rational number whose reciprocal does not exist. Now second, it is given the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal. So which are the numbers which are equal to their reciprocal? That are 1 and minus 1. If you are going to find the reciprocal of 1 and minus 1, that will be same. Here I am going to show you the questions also. Now here these are the questions. Now third, it is given that the rational number that is equal to its negative. So which is the number which is equal to its negative? So that is the 0. 0 negative will be also 0, so both are equal. So now the rational number that is equal to its negative is 0. Now fill in the blanks, it is given 0 has reciprocal. So 0 has no reciprocal. The 0 is the number whose reciprocal does not exist. The numbers are their own reciprocal. So which are the numbers which are their own reciprocal. So here you will fill 1 and minus 1. The reciprocal of minus 5. So what will be the reciprocal of minus 5? That will be minus 1 by 5. The reciprocal of 1 by x. So what will be the reciprocal of 1 by x? That will be x by 1. Here you can say x. The product of two rational numbers is always a, if you are going to multiply two rational number, again you will get a rational number. So the product of two rational number is always a rational number. The reciprocal of a positive rational number is a, so if you are going to find the reciprocal of a positive, then it will be positive, and the reciprocal of negative, that will be negative. So the reciprocal of a positive rational number is positive. So that is the question I had already discussed in the previous video also, and here I had revised that. So that is going to be completed exercise 1.1.